Hello, everybody. This is Ultimate Lifeform RB, and welcome to a new episode of Let's Play Mega Man 2 for the Nintendo Entertainment System. In our last episode, we took out Crash Man, Robot Master number 6, and we got our hands on the Crash Bomber. And now we are down to just two Robot Masters left to defeat, Heat Man and Bubble Man. And in this episode, we are going to take the fight to Bubble Man, so let's get to it, shall we? I love this music track, by the way. I'll just go ahead and get that out of the way. Then again, I could say that for a lot of the music in Mega Man 2. Definitely one of my favorite 8-bit soundtracks from the NES era. I love Mega Man 2's soundtrack, and Bubble Man's theme is one of my favorite music tracks in the game. But onto the level itself, this is the obligatory water-themed stage of the game. It seemed like every game on the NES had at least one of these stages. First, you're going to be going on these platforms while avoiding these frog robots. And now these platforms right here, some of them drop. You'll want to jump as soon as you land on one platform to go to the next one, because you never know which one is going to drop, and if you wait even a second before moving, you will fall off and die. Also, I apologize that the video was really acting weird on the waterfall section right there for that first part of the level. I don't know what happened, but looking at the playback of some of the recording, of some of the footage I recorded, there are a lot of imperfections in the video quality and stuff. I really don't know what's wrong, and I don't know what I can do about it. I guess it's just a side effect of recording with the Holopodge, because this is being recorded on my Holopodge HD PVR2. I am actually not playing the original NES version of Mega Man 2. I'm actually playing the Virtual Console version on the Wii. Anyway, back to the gameplay at hand. You just saw me use the Quick Boomerangs. These are the Quick Boomerang is the weapon that you get for defeating Quick Man. And in this underwater section, we are introduced to water physics. Now, this was the first Mega Man game to have proper water physics as we know them in video games. Basically, where for some reason, water basically functions like dry land, except with a lot of reduced gravity, at least for Mega Man. You can jump really, really high with Mega Man underwater in this level. And of course, the level designers saw to it that that would work against you, judging by all these spiked balls. Like anything else that's spiky, if you touch those spiked balls, Mega Man dies instantly. Which is interesting that this game has water physics, because the original Mega Man did not have water physics. In the original Mega Man, if you entered water, it was pretty much the same as being on dry land. Mega Man would jump and move normally. Now those frog enemies, they spawn little baby frogs that can be annoying to hit. But the good thing about the Quick Boomerang is that the way the Quick Boomerang moves, you can actually hit enemies that are low to the ground that other weapons cannot hit. Another good thing about the Quick Boomerang is that it has a lot of ammunition. In fact, I would rank it, like I said when we got it, after beating Quick Man, I would rank the Quick Boomerang as probably the second best weapon in the game. Anyway, we have reached the boss door, and it is time to take on Bubble Man. And according to what I've been told, the metal blades are Bubble Man's weakness. I guess because, you know, a pointy object hits a bubble, the bubble's gonna burst. Anyway, Bubble Man time. Let's see what's going on. And oh my god, bubbles! Deadly, deadly bubbles! But he's going to die. And that's it. Yeah. just use the metal blades and Bubble Man goes down like nothing. So that is another Robot Master down. We have only one left to do in order to move on to the final segment of the game. And we get equipped with Bubble Lead, which is Bubble Man's weapon. This weapon, I'm not quite sure how to feel about this weapon. It's, well, It shoots bubbles. You know, just gonna go ahead and say it. That's why it's called bubble lead. Which sounds lame. And I'll definitely would not put it among the, you know, the upper tier of weapons in this game, but you know, it has its uses. I mean, a lot of the weapons in Mega Man 2 are actually very useful. It's just that some of them are only useful in certain situations. Anyway, we've got just one Robot Master left, ladies and gentlemen, and we are going to stop here. So this is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. That's a wrap on this episode of Let's Play Mega Man 2 for the NES. If you folks liked what you saw in this video, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it as always. And I will see all of you in the next episode as we take on our final Robot Master of the game, Heat Man. See you then. Like what you see in this video? Want to see more? Then please support my channel by liking, commenting, and subscribing. I would greatly appreciate it, and also don't forget to like me on Facebook.